Neetshala presents Animal Kingdom in voice of Suyeshi Vineet. Animal Kingdom, Chapter 4. When you look around, you will observe different animals with different structures and forms. As over a million of species of animals have been described till now, the need for classification becomes all the more important. The classification also helps in assigning a systematic position to newly described species. 4.1 Basis of Classification. In spite of differences in structure and form of different animals, there are fundamental features common to various individuals in relation to arrangement of cell, body symmetry, nature of coelom, pattern of digestive, circulatory or reproductive system. These features are used as the basis of animal classification, and some of them are discussed here. So let's start with level of organization presented by Neetshala. 4.1.1 Levels of organization. Though all members of Animalia are multicellular, all of them do not exhibit the same pattern of organization of cells. For example, in sponges, the cells are arranged as loose cell aggregates, that is, they exhibit cellular level of organization. Some division of labor activities occurring in the cells, among the cells. I repeat, some division of labor occur among the cells. In coelenterates, the arrangement of cell is more complex. Here the cells performing the same function are arranged into tissues. Hence is called tissue level of organization. A still higher level of organization, that is, organ level, is exhibited by members of Platyhelminthes and other higher phyla, where tissue are grouped together to form organs, each specialized for a particular function. In animals like annelids, arthropods, mollusks, echinoderms and chordates, organs have associated to form functional systems, each system concerned with specific physiological function. This pattern is called organ system level of organization. Organ system in different groups of animals exhibit various pattern of complexities. For example, the digestive system in Platyhelminthes has only a single opening to the outside of the body that serves as both mouth and anus, and hence is called incomplete. A complete digestive system has two opening, mouth and anus. Similarly, the circulatory system may be of two types. First, open type, in which the blood is pumped out of the heart and the cell and tissue are directly bathed in it. Or the closed type, in which the blood is circulated through a series of vessels of varying diameters, arteries, veins and capillaries. Please like, share and subscribe to Neetshala. So let's move to the next topic, 4.1.2, Symmetry. Animals can be categorized on the basis of their symmetry. Sponges are mostly asymmetrical, that is, any plane that passes through the center does not divide them into equal halves. When any plane passing through the central axis of the body divides the organism into two identical halves, it is called radial symmetry. Coelenterates, ctenophores and echinoderms have this kind of body plan. Animals like annelids, arthropods, etc., where the body can be divided into identical left and right halves in only one plane, exhibit bilateral symmetry. 4.1.3 Diploblastic and triploblastic organization. Animals in which the cells are arranged into two embryonic layers, an external ectoderm and an internal endoderm, are called diploblastic animals. Example, coelenterates. An undifferentiated layer called mesoglia is present in between the ectoderm and the endoderm. Those animals in which the developing embryo has a third germinal layer, mesoderm, in between ectoderm and endoderm, are called triploblastic animals. Platyhelminthes to chordates. Coelom. 4.1.4 Coelom. Presence or absence of a cavity between the body wall and the gut wall is very important in classification. The body cavity, which is lined by mesoderm, is called siloam. Animals possessing siloam are called silomates. Example, annelids, mollusks, arthropods, echinoderms, hemichordates, and chordates. In some animals, the body cavity is not lined by mesoderm. Instead, the mesoderm is present as scattered pouches in between the ectoderm and endoderm. Such a body cavity is called pseudosiloam, and the animals possessing them are called pseudosilomates. Example, Ascii helminthus. The animals in which the body cavity is absent, are called acylomates. Example, Platyhelminthes. 4.1.5 Segmentation. In some animals, the body is externally and internally divided into segments with a serial repetition of at least some organs. For example, in earthworm, the body shows this pattern called metameric segmentation, and the phenomenon is known as metamerism. Notochord, 4.1.6. Notochord is a mesodermally derived rod-like structure formed on the dorsal side during embryonic development. In some animals, animals with notochord are called chordates, and those animals which do not form this structure are called non-chordates. Example, Porifera to echinoderms. Please like, share, and subscribe to Neetshala. Share your love to Neetshala. Classification of animals. 4.2 Classification of animals. The broad classification of animalia based on common fundamental features as mentioned in the preceding section is given in figure 4.4. Animalia, multicellular, cellular level shown by phylum Porifera. Tissue or organ level with radial symmetry is shown by Coelenterata, which is also known as Cnidaria or Ctenophora. Tissue or organ system of level of organization with bilateral symmetry without body cavity, acylomates, is shown by Platyhelminthes, whereas bilateral symmetry with false siloam, pseudosilomates, is reflected by Ascii helminthus, and with true siloam, that is silomates, is represented by phylum Annelida, Arthropoda, Mollusca, Echinodermata, Hemichordata, and Chordata. The important characteristic features of different phyla are described. 4.2.1 Phylum Porifera. Should we start or switch over to next video? Okay, I'm continuing because it's not even 10 minutes. And please do like, share, and subscribe to Neetshala. 4.2.1 Phylum Porifera. Members of this phylum are commonly known as sponges. They are generally marine and mostly asymmetrical animals. These are primitive multicellular animals and have cellular level of organization. Sponges have a water transport or canal system. Water enters through minute pores, ostia, in the body wall into a central cavity, spongocele, from where it goes out through the osculum. This pathway of water transport is helpful in food gathering, respiratory exchange, and removal of waste. Choanocytes or collar cells line the spongocele and the canals. Digestion is intracellular. The body is supported by a skeleton made up of spicules or spongine fibers. Sexes are not separate, that is, hermaphrodite. That is, egg and sperm are produced by the same individual. Sponges reproduce asexually by fragmentation and sexually by formation of gametes. Fertilization is internal and development is indirect, having a larval stage which is morphologically distinct from the adult. Examples include Cycon, Spongula, which is freshwater sponge, and Euspongia, which is bath sponge. 4.2.2 Phylum Coelenterata. They are aquatic, mostly marine, sessile or free swimming, radially symmetrical animals. They are also known as Cnidaria. The name Cnidaria is derived from the nidoblast or nidocytes, which contain the stinging capsule or nematocytes present on the tentacles and the body. Nidoblasts are used for anchorage, defense, and for the capture of prey. Nidarians exhibit tissue level of organization and are diploblastic. They have a central gastrovascular cavity with a single opening hypostome. Digestion is extracellular and intracellular. Some of the nidarians, example corals, have a skeleton composed of calcium carbonate. Nidarians exhibit two basic body forms called polyp and medusa. The former is sessile and cylindrical form like hydra, adamsia, etc., whereas the latter is umbrella shaped and free swimming like orella or jellyfish. Those nidarians which exist in both forms exhibit alternation of generation, metagenesis, that is, polyps produce medusa asexually and medusae forms polyps sexually. Example, Obelia. Examples include Physalia, Portuguese man of war, Adamsia, sea anemone, Penatula, sea pen, Gorgonia, sea fan, and Meandrina, brain coral. 4.2.3 Phylum Ctenophora. Ctenophores, commonly known as sea walnuts or comb jellies, are exclusively marine, radially symmetrical, diploblastic organisms with tissue level of organization. The body bears 8 external rows of ciliated comb plates which help in locomotion. Digestion is both extracellular and intracellular. Bioluminescence. The property of a living organism to emit light is well marked in ctenophores. Sexes are not separate. Reproduction takes place only by sexual means. Fertilization is external with indirect development. Examples of ctenophora includes pleurobrachia and ctenoplana. I repeat, pleurobrachia and ctenoplana. 4.2.4 Phylum Platyhelminthes. Please like, share, and subscribe to Neetshala. Platyhelminthes have dorsoventrally flattened body, hence are called flatworms. These are mostly endoparasites found in animals, including human beings. Flatworms are bilaterally symmetrical, triploblastic, and acellulomate animals with organ level of organization. Hooks and suckers are present in the parasitic forms. Some of them absorb nutrients from the host directly through their body surface. Specialized cells called flame cells help in the osmoregulation and excretion. Sexes are not separate. Fertilization is internal and development is through many larval stages. Some members like Planaria possess high regeneration capacity. Examples, Tania, tapeworm, and Fasciola. Liver fluke. 4.2.5 Phylum Aschehelminthes. The body of the Aschehelminthes is circular in cross section, hence the name roundworms. They may be free living, aquatic, and terrestrial or parasitic in plants and animals. Roundworms have organ system level of body organization. They are bilaterally symmetrical, triploblastic, and pseudocoelomate animals. Excuse me. Elementary canal is complete with a well-developed muscular pharynx. An excretory tube removes the body waste from the body cavity through the excretory pores. Sexes are separate, dioecious, that is, males and females are distinct. Often females are longer than males. Fertilization is internal and development may be direct. The young ones resemble the adult or indirect. Example, Ascaris, roundworm, Wuchereria, which is filaria worm, and ancylostoma. I repeat, ancylostoma, hookworm. 4.2.6 Phylum Annelida. They may be aquatic, marine and freshwater, or terrestrial, free-living, and sometimes parasitic. They exhibit organ system level of body organization and bilateral symmetry. They are triploblastic, metamerically segmented, and coelomate animals. Their body surface is distinctly marked out into segments or metameres, Latin annulus, little ring. hence the phylum name Annelida. They possess longitudinal and circular muscles which help in locomotion. Aquatic annelids like nereids possess lateral appendages, parapodia, which help in swimming. A closed circulatory system is present. Nephridia, singular nephridium, help in osmoregulation and excretion. I repeat, nephridia helps in osmoregulation and excretion. Neural system consists of paired ganglia, singular ganglion, connected by lateral nerves to a double ventral nerve cord. Nereis, an aquatic form, is dioecious, but earthworm and leeches are monoecious. Reproduction is sexual. Example include nereis, Ferritima, which is earthworm, and Hirudinaria, which is blood-sucking leech. 4.2.7 Arthropoda. This is the largest phylum of Animalia, which include insects. Over two-thirds of all named species on Earth are arthropods. I repeat, over two-thirds of all named species on Earth are arthropods. They have organ system level of organization, are bilaterally symmetrical, triploblastic, segmented, and coelomate animals. The body of arthropods is covered by chitinous exoskeleton. The body consists of head, thorax, and abdomen. They have jointed appendages. Arthros, meaning joint. Poda means appendages. Respiratory organ are gills, book lungs, or tracheal system. Circulatory system is of open type. Sensory organ like antenna, eye, compound and simple both. Statocysts or balance organ are present. Excretion takes place through malpighian tubules. They are mostly dioecious. Fertilization is usually internal. They are mostly oviparous. Development may be direct or indirect. Examples: economically important insects are Apis, that is honeybee, Bombyx, that is silkworm, Lacifer, that is lac insect. Vectors include Anopheles, Culex, and Aedes mosquito. Gregarious pests include locusta, which is locust, and living fossil is Limulus, which is king crab. 4.2.8 Phylum Mollusca. This is the second largest animal phylum. Mollusks are terrestrial or aquatic, marine or freshwater, having an organ system level of organization. They are bilaterally symmetrical, triploblastic, coelomate animals. Body is covered by a calcareous shell and is unsegmented with a distinct head, muscular foot, and a visceral hump. A soft and spongy layer of skin forms a mantle over the visceral hump. The space between the hump and the mantle is called the mantle cavity, in which feather-like gills are present. They have respiratory and expiratory function. The anterior head region has sensory tentacles. The mouth contains a file-like rasping organ for feeding called radula. They are usually dioecious and oviparous with indirect development. Examples include apple snail, which is Pila, pearl oyster, which is Pinctadata, sepia, cuttlefish, loligo, squid, octopus, devilfish, aplysia, sea hare, dentalium, tusk shell, and Catoplura, chiton. 4.2.9 Phylum Echinodermata. These animals have an endoskeleton of calcareous ossicles, and hence the name Echinodermata, spiny bodied. All are marine with organ system level of organization. The adult Echinodermata are radially symmetrical, but larvae are bilaterally symmetrical. I repeat, the adult echinoderms are radially symmetrical, but larvae are bilaterally symmetrical. They are triploblastic and coelomate animals. Digestive system is complete with mouth on the lower ventral side and anus on the upper dorsal side. The most distinctive feature of echinoderms is the presence of water vascular system, which helps in locomotion, capture and transport of food and respiration. An excretory system is absent. I repeat, an excretory system is absent. Sexes are separate. Reproduction is sexual. Fertilization is usually external. Development is indirect with a free swimming larva. Example include Asterias, starfish, Echinus, sea urchin, Antidon, sea lily, Cucumaria, sea cucumber, and of you are a brittle star. 4.2.10 Phylum Hemichordata. Hemichordata was earlier considered as a subphylum under phylum Chordata, but now it is placed as a separate phylum under non-Chordata. This phylum consists of a small group of worm-like marine animals with organ system level of organization. They are bilaterally symmetrical, triploblastic and coelomate animals. The body is cylindrical and composed of an anterior proboscis and a collar and a long trunk. Circulatory system is of open type. Respiration takes place through gills. Excretory organs is proboscis gland. Sexes are separate. Fertilization is external. Development is indirect. Example, Balanoglossus and Sacoglossus. Please like, share and subscribe to Neetshala. 4.2.11 Phylum Chordata. Animals belonging to phylum Chordata are fundamentally characterized by the presence of a notochord, a dorsal hollow nerve cord and paired pharyngeal gill slits. These are bilaterally symmetrical, triploblastic, coelomate with organ system level of organization. They possess a post-anal tail and a closed circulatory system. Table 4.1 presents a comparison of salient features of chordates and non-chordates. Chordates have notochord, whereas non-chordates do not have a notochord. Chordates have central nervous system, which is dorsal, hollow and single. The central nervous system is ventral, solid and double in case of non-chordates. Pharynx perforated by gill slits in case of chordates and gill slits are absent in non-chordates. Heart is ventral in chordates and heart is dorsal if present in non-chordates. A post-anal part tail is present in chordates. Post-anal tail is absent in non-chordates. Phylum Chordata is divided into three subphyla: Urochordata or Tunicata, Cephalochordata and Vertebrata. Subphylum Urochordata and Cephalochordata are often referred to as protochordates and are exclusively marine. I repeat, subphyla Urochordata and Cephalochordata are often referred to as protochordates and are exclusively marine. In Urochordata, notochord is present only in larval tail, while in Cephalochordata, it extends from head to tail region and is persistent throughout their life. Examples of Urochordata include Acidia, Salpa, Dolichium, Cephalochordata, Branchiostoma, Amphioxus or Lancelet. Members of subphylum Vertebrata possess notochord during embryonic period. The notochord is replaced by a cartilaginous or bony vertebral column in the adult. Thus, all vertebrates are chordates, but all chordates are not vertebrates. I repeat, all vertebrates are chordates, but all chordates are not vertebrates. Beside the basic chordate character, vertebrata have a ventral muscular heart with 2, 3, or 4 chambers, kidney for excretion and osmoregulation, and paired appendages which may be fins or limbs. The subphyla Vertebrata is further divided as follows: Agnatha, which lacks jaw; Gnathostoma, which bears jaw. Agnatha has class Cyclostomata. Gnathostomata has superclass Pisces and Tetrapoda. Pisces include class Chondrocythis and Osteocythis. Tetrapoda includes class Amphibia, Reptilia, Aves and Mammals. 4.2.11.1 Class Cyclostomata. All living members of class Cyclostomata are ectoparasites on some fishes. They have an elongated body bearing 6 to 15 pairs of gill slits for respiration. Cyclostomes have sucking and circular mouth without jaw. Their body is devoid of scales and paired fins. Cranium and vertebral column are cartilaginous. Circulation is of closed type. Cyclostomes are marine but migrate for spawning to fresh water. After spawning, within a few days they die. Their larvae, after metamorphosis, return to ocean. Examples include Petromyzon, Lamprey and Myxene hagfish. 4.2.11.2 Class Chondrocythis. They are marine animals with streamlined body and have cartilaginous endoskeleton. Mouth is located ventrally. Notochord is persistent throughout the life. Gill slits are separate without operculum gill cover. The skin is tough, containing minute placoid scales. Teeth are modified placoid scales, which are backwardly directed. Their jaws are very powerful. These animals are predaceous due to the absence of air bladder. They have to swim constantly to avoid sinking. Heart is two-chambered, one auricle and one ventricle. Some of them have electric organ, such as torpedo, and some possess poison sting, example trigon. They are cold-blooded, poikilothermous animals, that is, they lack the capacity to regulate their body temperature. Sexes are separate. In males, pelvic fins bear claspers. They have internal fertilization and many of them are viviparous. Examples include scolyodon, that is dogfish, pristis, which is sawfish, carchadon, which is great white shark, trigon, which is stingray. 4.2.11.3 Class Osteichthyes. It includes both marine and freshwater fishes with bony endoskeleton. Their body is streamlined. Mouth is mostly terminal. They have four pairs of gills, which are covered by an operculum on each side. Skin is covered by cycloid, ctenoid scales. Air bladder is present, which regulates buoyancy. Heart is two-chambered, one auricle and one ventricle. They are cold-blooded animals. Sexes are separate. Fertilization is usually external. They are mostly oviparous and development is direct. Examples include marine Exocetus, flying fish, hippocampus, seahorse, freshwater labio, rohu, katla, clarias, magur. Aquarium includes fighting fish, which is betta, pterophyllum, which is angel fish. 4.2.11.4 Class Amphibia. As the name indicates, Greek amphia, dual, bios, life. Amphibians can live in aquatic as well as terrestrial habitats. Most of them have two pairs of limbs. Body is divisible into head and trunk. Tail may be present in some. The amphibian skin is moist without scale. The eyes have eyelids. A tympanum represents the ear. Alimentary canal, urinary and reproductive tract is open into a common chamber called cloaca, which opens out to the exterior. Respiration is by gills, lungs and through skin. The heart is three-chambered, two auricle and one ventricle. These are cold-blooded animals. Sexes are separate. Fertilization is external and they are oviparous and development is direct or indirect. Examples include buffo, which is toad, rana, which is frog, hyla, which is tree frog, salamandra, which is salamander, ichthyophis, which is limbless amphibia. 4.2.11.5 Class Reptilia. The class name refers to their creeping or crawling mode of locomotion, Latin repair or reptum, to crawl or creep. They are mostly terrestrial animals and their body is covered by dry and cornified skin, epidermal scales or scutes. They do not have external ear opening. Tympanum represents ear. Limbs, when present, are two pairs. Heart is usually three-chambered but four-chambered heart in crocodiles. Reptiles are poikiotherms. Snakes and lizards shed their scales as skin cast. Sexes are separate. Fertilization is internal. They are oviparous and development is direct. Examples include chelone, which is turtle, testudo, which is tortoise, chameleon, which is free lizard, calotes, which is garden lizard, crocodilus, which is crocodile, alligator, which is alligator itself, hemidactylus, which is wall lizard, poisonous snake, naja, cobra, bangaras, which is crate, and vipera, which is viper. 4.2.11.6 Class Aves. The characteristic feature of aves, that is birds, are the presence of feathers and most of them can fly except flightless birds, example ostrich. They possess beak. The forelimbs are modified into wings. The hind limbs generally have scales and are modified for walking, swimming or clasping the tree branches. Skin is dry without glands except the oil gland at the base of the tail. Endoskeleton is fully ossified, bony, and the long bones are hollow with air cavities, pneumatic. The digestive tract of bird has additional chambers, the crop lizard. Herd is completely four-chambered. They are warm-blooded homo iothermous animals. That is, they are able to maintain a constant body temperature. Respiration is by lungs. Air sacs connected to lungs supplement respiration. Sexes are separate. Fertilization is internal. They are oviparous and development is direct. Examples include corvus, crow, columbia, columba, pigeon, cetacula, parrot, struthio, ostrich, pavo, peacock, aptenodictes, penguin, neophron, vulture. 4.2.11.7 class mammalia. They are found in a variety of habitats, polar ice caps, desert, mountains, forest, grassland and dark caves. Some of them have adapted to fly or live in water. They are mostly unique mammalian characteristic. The most unique mammalian characteristic is the presence of milk-producing gland, which is the mammary glands, by which the young ones are nourished. They have two pairs of limbs adapted for walking, running, climbing, burrowing, swimming, or flying. The skin of mammals is unique in possessing hair. External ear or pinna are present. Different type of teeth are present in the jaw. Heart is four-chambered. They are homo iothermous. Respiration is by lung. Sexes are separate and fertilization is internal. They are viviparous with a few exceptions and development is direct. Example, oviparous, ornithorhynchus platypus. Viviparous include macropus, kangaroo, pteropus, flying fox, camelus, camel, macaca, monkey, ratus, rat, canis, dog, felis, cat, elephas, elephant, equus, horse, delphinus, common dolphin, balaenoptera, blue whale, panthera, tigris, tiger, panthera, leo, lion. With this, we come to an end. Please like, share and subscribe to your Meet Shala.